All right, quick bin sale today. I would just went out there for like, I don't know, like half an hour, 45 minutes, maybe an hour tops, and I grabbed like $27 worth of stuff. These are immaculate 501s Levi's. I was really happy to find these. They're literally like, they feel new, like they've hardly been worn, like they're super stiff. And I checked them out. There's no stains. It's like all pristine, dude. They're even like nice, you know, like they were just off the rack, bro. You know, fucking 501 sizes, 36 by 30. That shit's gonna sell for like, I'm gonna put that up for like 25. I would love to get 30 for them. I don't know if that's possible. This is a Quicksilver utility core like jacket. It's a kid size though. I still grabbed it because it's super nice. Like I looked it over. There's no stains. There's like a little bit of dirt on it. That's fine. I don't know if this is gonna be a good pick. Kid stuff is doesn't sell for a lot, but I mean, you know, it's a badass like lined jacket. I mean, look at that shit. Freaking nice lined jacket, size 12, 10K, whatever the fuck that means. Hopefully this can get me, you know, maybe 15 bucks at least. We'll see. Shipping's gonna be a bitch though. And I think my theory is proving true that stuff that they price up, you know, 15 bucks for these lucky brands. I mean, that's pretty average. Usually you see lucky brands for like 20 or 25 or even 30 at the Goodwills that I go to. But, you know, that people just don't want to pay that much for them, so they're going to come to the bins. And maybe that's been the deal, and that's why everyone's hitting up the bins. I've been late to the party. You know, I've been doing other shit. But now, like I said, my number one plan now is just to go to the bins all the time. But yeah, these are just lucky brands. Women's size 0-25. Button fly on them. They're pretty nice shape. In pretty good shape. These are Paige jeans. Just a couple thread pulls here. I'll get that off with the pill shaver. Just a little bit of distressing on the back heel. I don't think that's a deal breaker, but look at that. I mean, they wanted 20 bucks for these. Nobody bought them. 32s, made in US. Paige. Maybe I can get 15. I sold two pairs of Paige jeans that were kind of, you know, beat up for like 15 bucks. So this is another kid's jacket. It's REI though. You know, it's really good shape on the outside. You know, inside there's a little bit of like dirt in here, but it's not bad. But I don't know, it's super lightweight, $1.89 a pound. I mean, this is probably like a buck, so I couldn't really pass that up. Even though it's kids, probably only ask 10 to 15 for this, but it's a badass jacket. Damn, this one was a kid size too. I thought this one was a regular large. I just looked at the tag, I saw large, but I didn't realize, yeah, it's got like the kid sizes and shit. And sure enough, it's super small. It's unfortunate because I really like this. I was gonna get it for myself, but I was gonna see if I could deal with the stains. Some stains here. That's a little unfortunate. Maybe it'll clean up, maybe it won't, but nonetheless, not a big loss. You see what I'm saying, guys? Like, the prices are so crazy. People just don't want to pay that. It's going to sit. It's going to go to the bins. This is a women's jacket. They wanted 30 bucks for it. It's a Marmot. Marmot's a great brand, you know, but anything with Marmot on it, they're going to price to the fucking sky. But, you know, there's no tag on this item, so that's probably why nobody bought it. You know, I'm just going to look at their measurement size charts and see if I can deduce the size of this thing. Shouldn't be too hard. It still has the materials tag. And I can look up the, should be able to look up the style code and stuff. It's 2012 model. It's a little old, a little older. But, I mean, this is a sick jacket. Marmot women's. So, hopefully I can at least get 15 bucks for this. Yeah, guys, and again, like, it's insane. Here's another pair. here's a pair of jeans for $30. Like, I'm not lying. Like, when I tell you that my Goodwill is priced shit, $25 to $30 for jeans that they consider to be a good brand. And these are Rag & Bone, a brand that I don't have a lot of experience with, but it's definitely on a lot of people's bolo lists that I've heard on YouTube. You know, I used to not pick it up, but now I'm going to start to try to pick it up because it is made in the USA. I don't know, it doesn't say, it says here, made in the USA. They're women's size 27. This is supposed to be like that, and they're in good shape, so, you know, I don't know how much I'm going to ask for those, maybe 15 to 20. I think it's just hilarious that, you know, Goodwill asks 30, yet I, on eBay, where you'd think it'd be a little bit more expensive than a freaking thrift store, like, I'm only going to ask 15 or 20, you know? I mean, it's crazy, bro. So I'm literally cheaper than Goodwill, so come to me. But Old Navy is a shitty brand, but this is new with tags. And, you know, just a nice pair of jeans. I mean, you can't really go wrong. They're skinny jeans, you know, new Old Navy jeans, 15-20. The last item here is this Torrid Super Soft Plush, size 2, made out of rayon polyester. It's like a turtleneck thing. And I heard turtlenecks are in style for chicks. I had literally heard a guy say that when I was there, so I don't know if he was right. But, you know, it's in good shape. It's got some pilling. I'll just shave that off with a pilling shaver. Shouldn't be a big deal. But other than that, it seems to be in good shape. And I don't know, I heard Torrid is a good brand. Again, I'm taking a chance. It could have not been, but I thought I heard on a bolo list that it was a good brand. But I could be wrong. But anyways, that's all I got today, $27. Do you think it was a good deal? Do you think it wasn't? You know, maybe two of these items will make that back and then the rest will be profit. You know, I don't know what the profit would be. You know, I mean, let's say I sell this for 25, 10, just on the low end, 15, 10, $5, $15, $15, $15, $10. That's like $130, you know, and I spent 30, so I think that's a pretty good investment, you know. But I mean, that's just estimations, and that's pretty low ball. You know, most of you are probably thinking you can get more for that, and it's probably true. So, I don't know. This is the start of a saga, and I will continue to frequent the bins and, you know, just learn the ins and outs of it. That's definitely going to be my number one sourcing spot from now on. I don't know why I slept on it for so long. I would literally just go to the thrift, the overpriced ass thrift, and I still managed, you know, to get my sales up to like $1,500 a week on eBay and Amazon and Poshmark and Mercari, like last summer when I was going hard, going to all these thrift stores all over the area. So, you know, I don't know why I didn't go to the bins before. I was just like, I figured you couldn't find good shit there. I figured you could only find, like, watching Daily Refinement and stuff, and he would sell everyday value, and I was like, man, I don't want to sell bullshit. Like, I want to sell good brands. So I would go to thrift stores and try to find good brands, but it's like, you know, I'm just using the same brand knowledge pretty much from the shit that I would buy at the thrift stores anyways, and they seem to have a lot of decent stuff at the bins. So, you know, time to go to the bins, you know, and the price is so cheap, you know, I can afford to buy shit that I wouldn't buy normally at the thrift store, and, you know, even branch out to more everyday value brands and learn the ins and outs of what is popular with, like, shitty brands. And yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more content. Peace.